The government's credibility, as we all know, continues to slide. The public anger continues to rise. Between the Goldman ripoff scams and the disability and Social Security ripoff scams, mandated health care into an unreformed monopoly, Bush tax cuts, you pick your favorite thing, Medicare Part D. We all know the politicians are working for their friends and not for us. But at the end of the day, is it the bleeding heart liberals who are the most to blame for the people's lack of confidence in their leaders? Today we have one person who says, indeed, that is the case. Mark Tapscott from the Washington Examiner joins us now. Mark, the floor is yours, sir.
Thank you, Dylan. You know, one of the reasons why I so appreciate your giving me the opportunity to come on your show and offer my rant is I'm aware of MSNBC's demographics, which suggests that probably a good many of the people watching me right now are not going to agree with what I have to say. There are probably people who won't agree with what I say because I'm a conservative editorial page editor. But let's put aside our stereotypes for a minute and have a heart-to-heart talk about something that's very important. That's the loss of credibility by government, especially government here in Washington. You know, Scott Rasmussen, the pollsters, found out this last week that only 23% of the American people believe that government has the consent of the government. And Gallup just found that Congress has the worst confidence rating, public confidence rating, that it's ever had. Now, George Bush and the Republican Congresses of most recent time deserve a fat share of the blame here, too. Too often they said one thing, but then they did the exact opposite. But I really think that folks on the liberal side, a lot of them are crosswise with most Americans, too. And the reason for that has to do with one of your basic premises. I think Ronald Reagan said it best in 1981 when he said these words.
In this present crisis, government is not the solution to our problem. Government is the problem. From time to time, we've been tempted to believe that society has become too complex to be managed by self-rule, that government by an elite group is superior to government for, by, and of the people. Well, if no one among us is capable of governing himself, then who among us has the capacity to govern someone else?
You know, that's that is, to me, the very heart of the problem here, the issue that we have here, because too many of my liberal friends think that they are indeed eminently qualified to tell the rest of us how to live. And they look down their noses, quite frankly, at mainstream Americans as a bunch of misguided boobs at best, or at worst, unregenerate racist. You know, we're becoming what Arthur Brooks of AEI calls a 70-30 nation, where 70% of us want less government and more freedom, and 30% of us want more government and more power to tell the rest of us how to live. Worst of all, too often the 30% seem quite comfortable with tactics like the Cornhusker bargain and the Louisiana Purchase. Remember those from the healthcare push? To get their way. So it's just democracy be damned. And this attitude is undercutting the very public trust on which a democratic republic stands or falls. So I say to my friends on the left, please rethink your views about your fellow mainstream Americans before it's too late.
Mark, thank you so much for the rant. I've got some breaking news here, so I'm not going to. I got a couple of questions that I pepper you with, but I know we're pals and we do the show every day, so I'll leave it at that. But thank you so much, Mark Tapscott, with our daily rant.